like I seen people getting into more, right? And then of course the back, okay? Those are the two that I see people having more problems in order to escape, right? So let's start with the one on the side control. I think I showed it before, right? But I'm gonna show one more time, okay? So, so as soon as I'm on side control, what I really don't understand, even before, sometimes I feel that Carlin is getting like really close to pass my guard, and then I see some of you guys genius. I honestly I don't know why, you know, because I wanna try to create space in here. She's getting close to me. If I do this, she just have to lay down here, boom, and then you guys stay in here, all right? So that's not what I want. I want to touch gray space. So when I feel that Carlin is coming close to pass my guard, so the first thing that I want to try to do is to lock my elbows. That's the first thing. All right? Like for me, in my case, I prefer that someone pass my guard than to get my back. Not that I prefer, but I think it's less terrible, all right? But if they pass, all right? Now we're gonna learn, okay? Lock your elbows. Second thing, I'm always gonna do this, the defense of the mount, always, okay? That way it's gonna get more complicated for her to go for the mount, okay? Second thing, I'm not gonna escape on the time that I want. If she's really heavy here and she's putting pressure, if I try to work my way out of here, I'm gonna try to explode a lot, and I'm not even gonna move him, and I'm just gonna waste energy. And then I'm gonna do it here. She's gonna be here, and then boom, I give her. Now it's the time that she's gonna move, and then I don't have so much energy in order to defend, because this was going to be the time that I need in order to explode. All right? So I'm gonna have to feel when she's not with the same pressure, maybe she's moving, maybe she's going to try to go for someplace else, all right, in here. Maybe she's going to try a choke, I don't know, whatever. That's the moment that I have to explode. If she's like really tight on me, I don't even try, I just try to protect myself and wait for the best moment. Okay, makes sense in here? Yes or no? Yeah. All right, so lock it in here. So now let's go for one more time. I wanna try to use, as soon as she moves, now is the time that I wanna create space. I wanna make a hip escape, okay? But it's very important that when I make the hip escape, my head goes away, all right? So I see some people also, when I push, and I want to touch quick, do a hip escape, you do this. You see the head gets close. And then I can use my legs in here in order to recover. All right? So when I do the hip escapes, and when she, I feel that the pressure is not so much, I want to push, and I want to touch move my head away. Okay? I want to touch move my head away. Now I'm going to do the hip escapes with my head being away. So I can escape in here, I make space for my knee to come inside. Okay, now we got two options in here, all right? If I am really flexible, I can pass my leg all over here like this, and then I can push, use the leg to push, pull the other leg like this, and now I just stay always in here, make grips on her. All right, if I want to pull her to the close guard, it's very important that I use here on the sleeves. Don't try to go in here, like this. Okay, like this is easy for her to move away. All right, if I can pull in here on the sleeves, or even better here on the triceps, now it's even better, boom, it's full. Now she's on the close guard. Okay, so if I am not so flexible, all right, same way, wait for her, she doesn't have the same pressure anymore, Okay, so escape, boom, use the leg. And now, my other leg has to come really close to my other leg in here, like this. I wanna hold in here on the triceps, and then I wanna pull in here, and now I pull the triceps, like this, and then I open. So I can create space. See, now my head is far from her again. But I can't stop it in here. If I stop it in here, she's still gonna be passing. She still has an opportunity here to go back to the same position. Okay? So as soon as I do this, right? I always stay with this hand in here away. If she tries to come close to me, I push. Alright? And now what I'm gonna do? I wanna try to bring my other leg in here up, go on the hips. And now since I have this grip in here on the triceps, I just pull her to me, boom, back close behind. Alright? I can either do this or I can do a technical stand up if I want, like we saw it before. If I wanna go for a stand up, I can also do it. Okay?
Can
yes.
Can you show how you would do a technical stand up from this point? Like
so from here, when I wanna do the technical stand up, okay? How I'm gonna use? I have different ways of working, okay? But the one that we're gonna have to use is the one that we wanna create space. So I'm gonna use my foot in here, like this, in order to push. So I wanna push, and now I wanna do one more hip skips. Go here, over my elbow. See it up, all right? And now I have to understand, if she's holding this leg in here, okay? If she's holding this leg in here, all right? It's not a problem, I can still stand up, okay? But how am I gonna do? Create space, okay? Now put the foot on the mat, technical stand up. As she, when she goes in here, you see, she's still gonna try to attack. It's very important that I twist my knee all the way in here. Just like she's gonna go to attack my leg. That's what I wanna do. Put the head down, okay? Sprawl, so I can escape one more time, all right? Has to be everything very fast, okay? So I'm already waiting for her to do this, all right? I should wait this way. If she, for some reason, if she holds the other leg, you see? That's, and then she starts pulling this leg to her, I won't be able to do the technical stand up. So not a problem. So what I do, just switch the side. Okay, switch the side, and then I'm gonna be doing the same thing. Boom, boom. Move away, right? It's gonna be a fight in there. It's not gonna be so easy. Okay, but at least you have a chance there in order to escape, okay? All right? Guys, any question on this? On those two? Yes. No. Copy. Yes or no?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. So
say now or don't talk.
Okay. So maybe I misunderstood when I was being taught this before, but I mean a lot of times people have said like when somebody gets me in side control, I should not let them stabilize like in that first 10 seconds. Yeah.
That's totally true. I'm gonna fight. Uh-huh. As much as I can. I don't want to accept any kind of immobilization that my opponent is having over me. I'm going to fight as much as I can. But there is no time that this one going to make more sense for me to keep fighting. Because right. She already got the position. So that's the time that I want to breathe. Okay, I want to think. And then I want to do my next move.
Okay.
Because it changes. Now it's not the time for you to just scramble.
Right.
If I keep doing this, I'm gonna waste energy, she's gonna be really heavy. It doesn't matter the difference, but imagine if she's already like this, for me. I don't think I can escape if she doesn't want. If she really stays in here, heavy, okay, like this, shoulder on my face, even for me to speak, it's hard, imagine for me to escape, like this, with this pressure. So that's why, sorry, all right? So that's why I lock it in here, and then I touch it. If she's putting a lot of pressure, that's why my hand goes in here on the shoulder, and I try to push and take my shin out. All right, now put the pressure. So the pressure is not gonna be so great. So I'm waiting here. She has to move. When she move, boom. That's the time that I wanna explore.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, but like if we are, just go back just a little bit.
A little bit.
If we are here, I'm playing guard with her, and then Carlin, stop passing, do any kind of pass. From here, I gotta, now is the time that I have to explode. Mm-hmm. Boom, everything that I wanna do. Okay, mm-hmm. Now is the time, because then it will be nothing. But if I'm still fighting, and then she's already locked on me, then it's gonna be hard. Man. Mm-hmm. Now we're gonna have to change your strategy. Make sense?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, but you're always gonna fight. You're gonna fight for a sweep, you're gonna fight to defend a sweep, okay? Mm-hmm. Always. I like to say that you don't wait for something to happen so you can defend. Mm-hmm. Or actually escape. Okay. This is more like escape, it's not even defend. Defend, a defense is gonna be when we are in here, Kalin start passing, try to pass, and then I'm here blocking. Next, I'm defending myself. From here, she's already here. Now I gotta have to escape. It's changing. Make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. All right. So, questions. So let's work on this.